Diversity in AI. How is diversity impacting your data? How is it impacting your algorithms, your AI, and your results? We're here at MWC at the EY booth, and I'm here with Errol Gardner. You're the Global Vice Chair Consulting at EY. And we're going to dive deeper in more diversity approaches to improve your data. Can you explain why diversity is so important, and specifically from a data perspective, from an AI perspective?
Yeah, maybe before I start with that, just to kind of say one of the things that we're driving here, and welcome to our EY booth,
Thank you, of course.
But one of the streams that we're sponsoring here at MWC is diversity for tech. So we feel very strongly about the need for the technology industry more broadly to have more diversity in terms of the people that work within that industry, and especially obviously in leadership positions to drive these organizations forward. And so we've got a big track, a lot of things that we'll be doing tomorrow around that, and so delighted to be talking about that with you today. But to answer your question, I think why it's important and where we should drill into some of this is, if you think about the nature of the industry that is a technology industry, one of the real benefits that it has is by definition that it's very universal, that you have in the building components of what makes up the tech sector, and with data and AI and others, the languages which are native to software and systems development, which are universal and are therefore less of a barrier to entry. And so I think you see people from around the world engaging with this industry. But if you look at the other side of it, that fundamentally the importance of technology in the world now is that it's driving everything. And yeah, if we're open about it, it's obviously the most valuable organizations in the world are technology companies or are very, very heavily technology focused. And then similarly, you have the situation that, you know, organizations that hitherto are actually in industries which are not technology focused are becoming much more like technology firms and companies themselves as well. So then it's really important from an engagement of people and customers and whoever they may be, as well as in terms of the success that this business is driving and the growth that it's driving, that it's actually bringing in as broad a church of people as possible. And I think that's fundamental to the success of the industry and its longer term success, but also fundamentally to make sure that some of the solutions that are being built from a customer's perspective, from supply chains, in terms of how we look at employee engagement, that they are considering as diverse a set of people in terms of doing that. So happy to talk about that as well.
And you're talking about the tech industry, it's different. If we talk about diversity, many people immediately think about gender.
Yeah.
But it's much broader. Can you explain how it's much broader, but also what kind of impact it has on either results or on the data that they collect, on the algorithms that they create?
Yeah, and I think we've seen some really good examples with algorithms that have been created by organizations leveraging data sets that have been selected by certain people, which do not reflect necessarily the superset, if you like, or universal set of potential customers, suppliers, and others that organizations should be looking at. Employees is another classic example, and therefore if you're using data sets which are not a true reflection of the world that you're existing in or who you want your customer base to be, I think that presents challenges. The algorithm will only read the data that is sitting there and then come up with the answers as a consequence. And then the challenge with that, if that is not seen, spotted, understood, then you will naturally start building solutions. And we've seen examples of that where algorithms or data sets have been set up and piloted, tested, algorithms have been run, results have been proved out, everybody's comfortable, we launch things, and then suddenly you get some results in the real world that don't reflect actually how it works, and you have issues of discrimination in certain, it could be for instance, where you do sifting of resumes to join an organization. It could be how you do customer onboarding and whether somebody's profile is appropriate or not. That because you pick the wrong pilot data, that can cause issues. And And if people in the value chain of coming up with those answers don't see that, and don't have the mindset or the vision to see that, that obviously then causes challenges down the line.
And can you share key pillars or key approaches that you discuss with clients, how to include this diverse approach?
Well, I think part of it is in any, as you know, any process where you're setting up test data, setting up environments where you want to test ideas to get to production, you have various gating processes in place that you want to make sure from a control and various other perspective that you're proving your hypothesis. Mm-hmm. But if you don't have the right people then engaged in those control processes, and arguably also in the development processes themselves, then you're going to have some of these challenges. So I think it's both having the people engaged, both in the development of the solutions and what you're testing, but then also in the gating process to ask the right questions. But then ultimately to make sure that those control procedures are holistic enough to incorporate some of these challenges that we've seen.
Errol, thanks a lot for this great insight on how diversity really can impact your results and your reduce the bias basically and improve the solutions that you build. Thanks a lot.
Okay, you're very welcome. Great to meet you.
Yeah, great to meet you, and let's enjoy MWC for the coming days.
Absolutely, thank you.